So here I was doing observation videos in this observation hive of a queen in her queen cell, and I'm waiting for her to hatch. And wouldn't you know it, all of a sudden, the bees in the observation hive erupt into all of this activity. So if you don't know this yourself, when the hive gets active like this, what you're about to experience is a swarm. So these bees are headed out, and often they do swarm just before subsequent queens hatch out. And that's what's happening here. So I turned off all my video gear, pulled the lights to the side, and now we're just going to share what's going on through the observation hive to show you what it looks like when workers swarm out with an older queen. Now, this observation hive has only been in use since, let's say, March or April. So there is still some brood here. There is no open larvae. And there are already queen cells, of course, that are capped. So they're swarming out. And here's the opening. It goes through the bottom. There's a tube that goes to the exterior. And here's what the outside landing board looks like. Now, if you weren't paying attention to your beehives and you were somewhere else, this all happens very fast. This entire video is only 12 minutes, and I'm giving it to you real time here. This is what an entrance looks like when bees are swarming out. And I'll get you in close so you can hear the buzzing of the bees as they come and go. Now, when the bees swarm out, wherever the queen lands, that's where they'll form a swarm, and that's why you sometimes see them hanging on a tree branch or a fence post or something else like that. So we'll keep an eye out now that we know they're swarming, and I'm going to show you where they land and how they congregate. And you'll notice there are several trees in the background here that are within 100 feet of this hive. And it's likely that they're going to go to one of these trees, land on a branch, and that will allow me to collect them and, of course, put them in another hive body. I was hoping to catch the queen flying out, but it happened so fast. And it's a hot day. It's in the 80s. We have a nectar flow coming in. The goldenrod is right now getting into bloom. The asters are blooming, and there's lots of pollen out there. So hive resources were very strong before they started this swarm. And you can see, even while most of the hive, about 50% of the occupants of this hive, are flying out, there are still worker bees from the field that are coming in with pollen on their legs. And now, sure enough, here's a blue spruce tree, and we can see that they are focusing their flight around this tree. So we know that that queen is going to land on one of these branches, and hopefully they'll land low enough that we can get a hold of them and collect the swarm after it congregates here on one of these branches. So this is a Colorado blue spruce tree, and the interesting thing is we've often gotten swarms off of this tree in the past, so they do tend to reuse the same branches in the same locations to collect before they spread out to their new location. And here they are. So that must mean the queen has landed on this branch, and so the workers are now creating a swarm around her to protect the queen while scouts go out. And even though I'm a little frustrated, of course, that I'm losing half the strength of the colony in the observation hive that I'm working with, it is also an opportunity to share how swarms happen and then, you know, what the process is. So we'll just go ahead and video this activity and show you what the bees do. Now keep in mind, back inside the observation hive, about 50% of the bees are still there, and there are broods, so the colony's not doomed. And just showing you that I'm not wearing any protective clothing here, just following the bees around until I can get them in a position to come back and collect them. And as swarms go, this is really not a very big one. Even once all the workers collect on this branch, we're talking maybe 2 to 3 pounds of bees. And you notice that even some of the workers that are in the swarm, they have resources with them. They have pollen, and most of them have filled up on honey resources before they flew out, because they need to survive for the next 24 to 72 hours. While they think they're going to find a new location, but I'm going to locate them in a new hive body myself. And of course, while I'm making this video, some of the worker bees are, of course, landing on me and landing on the camera, and they may land in your hair if you're this close to a swarm. But remember that this is not a hive. This is not a colony. In swarm mode, they're looking for a new place to live, and therefore, they're not defensive. So unless you're allergic to bees, or there's some other reason why you're concerned about being stung, there really is very little chance that you're going to be stung when you're following up on a swarm. So the bees are in survival mode. They really don't want to give up their lives to defend something that they're only going to occupy for a small amount of time. And when there is a swarm, the queen that has left the colony is always the older queen. And she's driven out by the workers. It's anyone's guess. This queen was laying well. She was laying eggs in every available cell. She was productive. It's anyone's guess as to why the workers suddenly turn on a queen and decide to chase her around and stop feeding her and get her to lose weight so that she can fly out and start a new colony elsewhere. A lot of people spend a lot of time trying to figure out why their bees swarm. Sometimes there is no real rhyme or reason. I mean, you could stop a swarm by taking out the queen, and then of course the workers would remain in the colony, or if you took the queen out of the swarm, they would return to the colony they left. And these are the residual bees, and you can see the activity inside now is calming down quite a bit. Most of these are going to remain in this observation hive. And again, this is the entry point to the hive at the bottom there. Now, this is the queen cell that I was actually observing. I was planning to have her hatch out and get macro video of it, and did not anticipate that they would swarm so soon. Within 48 hours of this swarm, that queen cell did hatch out, and we do now have a virgin queen in this colony. And this is the video gear that I was using to do the macro sequences of the queen hatching behavior, which of course was interrupted now by the swarm activity. Now notice the outside landing board. If I had not been there and had not noticed the behavior, walking around a regular honeybee colony, you would look at a landing board and this looks normal. You would have no idea that they had swarmed out to an adjacent tree like this. So now I'm just going to go and get a ladder and a bucket and collect this swarm and get them in a hive so that we can try to get them to survive. Their chances are low. It's mid-August, and here's the ladder. I've already taken the swarm away and put them in a body, but they're going to need resources. I'm going to have to feed them, and we're going to have to really kind of coddle them through the winter here because there won't be time for them to build up. Here's the box I put them in. So this is a standard 10-frame honeybee hive, and here's the bucket next to it that I used to collect them. You can see that they are going in and out, they're fanning, and they're controlling it. You can take a frame of brood from one of your other hives if you have it. You can put that in the deep box here, and they're less likely to abandon a frame of capped brood. So that's just one method you can use. I don't have to with these guys, I think. All of these bees are going to stay, and they did. So I hope you enjoyed that. A little frustrating for me to lose the bees in the middle of a project, but an opportunity to inform you about honeybees and swarming. Thanks for watching.